Well, I think, you know, you see a lot more of this in the House, and I've talked a little bit about the cultural differences of the House and the Senate, and one of those big differences, I think, is that the House, the rules of procedure in the House are probably used more in an obstructive way in the House, and I don't mean that in a negative way. I think that that's part of the culture, and it's meant to be that way. I think in the Senate, because of the things that I mentioned before, because it is the two-thirds tradition builds consensus, there's less of a need for it. And that's one of the reasons you don't see a lot of points of order called in the Senate, because if you've worked and you've got a two-thirds with you, rules are suspended by the same vote. So if there's a point of order, you might get a motion to suspend the rule that you just called a point of order on. And it just doesn't really make much sense once you go that far. And actually, I know of an instance where someone had called a point of order years ago, and apparently the I wasn't parliamentarian. The parliamentarian said, "Are you sure you want to do that?" And the senator said, "Yeah, here's rule number. I'm calling a point of order." He called the point of order, and the opposing senator got up and said, "What's that rule number again?" He said, "Oh, okay, I'd like to move to suspend that rule." They suspended it and they moved on, and the senator was sitting there going, "What just happened to me?" So you're not going to see a lot of that in the Senate. You'll see the rules used a lot more in the House. But the way you kill bills, the easiest way to kill a bill is in committee. If you can persuade a chairman that a bill doesn't deserve to see the light of day, that's great. You've killed it, from the start. Now you still have to watch out for an amendment to another bill in the process. But you can kill the bill on, using the two-thirds tradition in the Senate. You can kill it in the Calendars Committee in the House. You might be able to kill it on just those time frames that we talked about. And maybe if you're lucky, you can delay it long enough to where it gets caught at the end, and its placement on the House calendar is a lot lower, and they just didn't have time and they didn't get to it. Those things are just, it's easier to do all that than it is to persuade 181 people that a bill and a policy that you're trying to pass deserves passage.